Several Republican senators seem to be following the president's lead and the lead of his legal team, turning the impeachment trial of President Trump into a trial of former Vice President Joe Biden and his son, Hunter. Florida Senator Rick Scott is one of them. Check out his latest ad, one that's running in Iowa ahead of the caucuses next week.
I'm Rick Scott, one of the jurors in the U.S. Senate. I'd like to thank the Democrats for badly botching this impeachment charade and for spending so much time in a cover-up for Joe Biden. The real story here is the corruption Joe Biden got away with. Vice President Biden threatened a foreign country and forced him to fire a prosecutor who was investigating a company paying his son $83,000 a month. Biden got away with it, and his son got paid. I'm Rick Scott, and I approve this message.
Wow. That is just astounding. Let's just do a quick bit of fact-checking on that before we throw this to the panel. When Vice President Biden called for the firing of the Ukrainian prosecutor, he was carrying out U.S. policy in accordance with what anti-corruption activists in Ukraine wanted done. Viktor Shokin, the prosecutor in question, was perceived to be corrupt. He was carrying out what the International Monetary Fund wanted done, the World Bank, European allies. One can certainly question whether or not Hunter Biden should have been on the board of a Ukrainian company during the period that his father was running Ukrainian policy in the United States. But it is, there has been no proof that Vice President Biden did anything corrupt whatsoever. Gloria Borger.
I'm Rick Scott, and I'm running for president in 2024. That's what this
is. Pretty clear.
This is about who's the heir, and of course, John knows more about this than anyone. Who is the heir here? And this ad in Iowa? Gee, where is Rick Scott from? Florida? Even Rick Santorum is agreeing with me, shaking his head. And, you know, this is about Rick Scott saying, look at me, recognize me, I'm on the Trump train.
Yeah.
Here I am. I'm a natural heir, and remember me for the next cycle.
But should he be doing this, John, while he's a juror in the U.S. Senate and we're waiting for his decision?
In a civics or good government textbook, no. In the age we live in, not just the Trump age, this is, you know, the Clinton, I don't remember ads like this during the Clinton impeachment trial, but it was very political in what was said in the discourse there. It's not surprising. No, in the sense, does it fit for a sitting senator for another state? Right before the caucuses, because the answer is so strong, no, it makes perfect sense in the age we live in, where you have, look, you have, you know, we talked about this yesterday, Secretary Pompeo attacking journalists and then issuing statements celebrating his attack on journalists instead of saying, you know, maybe we both had a bad
day,
let's move on. There's the Vice President of the United States is thinking about running. The former South Carolina governor who had, you know, was more muted when she left the administration, suddenly very Trumpy, Nikki Haley of late. This is a competition. A, it helps you in two ways. You stay on the president's good side now, you don't get the Twitter chainsaw directed your way, and you get into conversations like this, which doesn't hurt.
Yeah, and you potentially damage Biden, right? You cut his knees off in Iowa, at least you try to, in the way that Joni Ernst is sounding like a pundit saying, oh, she wonders what this focus on Biden means for the Iowa caucuses. So, yeah, I mean, I think maybe it's an effective ad. I don't think most people in Iowa know who Rick Scott is. He's not sort of the most charismatic politician. He's probably got to work on that if he wants to run for president in 2024. But, yeah, I mean, this was the whole plan, right? Donald Trump wanted to weaken Joe Biden, which is why he wanted some dirt on him from the Ukrainian president. And the idea was to probably weaken him during the primary and knock him out of the primary so he wouldn't face him in the general. So I think that is in keeping with the grand plan. Rick is disagreeing with me.
I think the whole premise of this whole investigation, that somehow a Ukrainian president announcing an investigation is going to have a material effect on this election. It would not, given all the, I mean, it had zero impact on this election. Number one, on the Rick Scott issue, look, I mean, I didn't know this, but Rick's running for president. I mean, it's pretty clear. There's no other rational interpretation of what Rick Scott is doing.